In this video, we're going to finish the CUDA Software Infinite Geometry Free Worksheet Translations. Our directions for the second page are to write a rule to describe each transformation. And here's a little hint, if this is a translations worksheet, we're going to be using translations. So in order to go from Z to Z prime, we move down one unit and to the right two units. So number 7 will be a translation that's 2 units right and 1 unit down. Now let's double check with the other points. Looking at I, we're moving 2 units to the right and 1 unit down to get to I prime. So that checks for point I. We already checked Z. And for K, we're moving 1 unit down and 2 to the right. Or we can move 2 to the right first and 1 unit down. That's K prime. So in number 7, we indeed have a translation that's 2 units right and 1 unit down. In number 8, we're looking from how to get to V prime. That's 1 unit to the left and 1 unit up. So in number 8, we have a translation of 1 unit left and 1 unit up. So again, when we're trying to describe the translation, we're going from our original figure to the figure labeled with our primes. So V, 1 unit to the left, 1 unit up to V prime. Double checking with T, we're going 1 unit to the left and 1 unit up to get to T prime. Double checking with I, 1 unit to the left and 1 unit up to get to I prime. And finally, double checking with J, 1 unit to the left and 1 unit up to get to J prime. So you can think of this as negative 1 in the x direction and positive 1 in the y direction. And number 9, to go from u to u prime, we're simply moving 1 unit to the right. N to n prime, 1 unit to the right. And h to h prime, 1 unit to the right. So we know that we have a translation that is just 1 unit right, because we're not moving any in the vertical direction. So we're not moving up or down in the y direction, we're just moving horizontally in the x direction. In number 10, to go from A to A prime, we're going to have to go down 1, 2, 3 units and to the right 1. So our translation is 1 unit right, writing our x translation first, and then 3 units down. Then writing our y translation. So double checking with L, 1 unit right and 3 units down will get us to L prime. And lastly, double checking with P, 1 unit to the right and 3 units down will indeed get us to P prime. And number 11, starting at H to get to H prime, we're going 2 to the left and 1 down. So this is going to be a translation, 2 units left and 1 unit down. Double checking with Y, 2 units to the left and 1 unit down will get us to Y prime. Double checking with W, 2 units to the left and 1 unit down to W prime. And then for N, we can see that in relation with H, N is 2 down and 1 to the left. So looking in relation with H prime, 2 down and 1 to the left is N prime. So looking at the translation, 1 down, 2 to the left, we do indeed get N prime. And lastly in this video, number 12. T appears to be at 5 units to the left of, let's say, this point is 0, 0. So that means that T would be negative 5, 0. T prime appears to be negative 5, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 is the coordinate negative 5, 4 for T prime. So you can see that my values in the x direction do not change. Negative 5 is the same as negative 5, but my y values change from 0 to 4. So that's a positive 4 in the y direction. Therefore, my translation is just 4 units up. And let's double check. T to T prime, 1, 2, 3, 4 units in the positive y direction. P to P prime, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then V to B prime, 1, 2, 3, 4. And with that, I wrap up this worksheet. Hopefully you understand a few different methods for describing a translation and understanding how a translation works. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you haven't already, like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated.